So, a little bit about the so-called reptilians. Well, when I first stumbled about these stories, first I heard them from David Icke. When I first stumbled about them, I thought, wow, that's pretty nutty. That's really wacko as wacko can be. But then I watched this lecture about that lecture he gave in Brighton. It was a 6-hour video, and somehow I managed to watch the whole thing, not in one washing. And there I think I kind of understood what he means by reptos, by reptilian shapeshifters. He's not referring to people that actually transform, like the Transformers in the movie, into some kind of reptiloid humans or humanoid reptilians. And when he's speaking about the people that told him that they saw people transform, methinks that not those people were changing their appearance, but the observers were changing their mode of perception, so to speak. They were watching on another plane, or they were receiving information from another plane with their perception. So, because when you understand it that way, the reptilian story makes sense a little bit. Those people, I have to go back a little bit. You see, for example, in the yogic traditions in India, they work with the chakras in the body, and in the lowest chakra, the Kundalini serpent is dormant. And in similar other systems, there are, for example, in the Kabbalah, but also in modern psychology, there are similar ideas. Well, psychology is not talking about Kundalini or a serpent power or something like that, but there are parallels. Well, watch my lectures about magic series. It's a bit complicated to understand, but you might get the idea. Those people that were perceived as changing into reptilian form, they are psychologically locked in their lowest in the lowest parts possible. So in the chakra system, they are locked in the lowest chakra. In psychology, they are more working with the reptilian brain than with the empathic parts of the brain. When you understand it that way, it makes sense. But all the other stuff about reptilians living in a kind of underworld and in cities under the earth and stuff like that, that's bullshit. As a matter of fact, some psychologists, I don't know who it was, but some psychologists discovered some years ago that people that are in high positions in business have so to speak, the same psychological malfunctions that those people have that are successful in crime. So from a psychological perspective, they are equal. The only point is, the only difference is, the one kind manages to be successful in business, and they are successful in appearing to be good citizens, and the others don't give a shit about that. So there's another proof that this not so exciting view on the reptilians might be the better way to look at it, and just forget about that UFO stuff and reptiloid and all that stuff. It might sound exciting, but you shouldn't take it serious. It doesn't resist Occam's knife. Occam's razor, sorry. So that's it for this episode. Let's see what's up next.